this is VSB TV 11 News for Thursday, March 20th. I'm Peter Cattell. The jury in the court case for the attempted murder trial of Devon Huey and Servio Cox deliberated since 11 a.m. this morning. At press time, they had not reached a verdict. Devon Huey and Servio Cox are on trial for attempting the murder of two men outside of Shine's nightclub in March 24th of 2012. The two men allegedly rode by the nightclub on a motorcycle and opened fire, and then allegedly rode to Botanical Gardens, where they allegedly left the motorbike that they were said to have been riding. The court case has been ongoing for 2 months, and this afternoon the jury came into court multiple times with questions. It is expected that they will reach a verdict tomorrow morning. A third man was on trial in the same case, but was recently acquitted. There has been an immediate result of the police appeal for public vigilance to offset the rash of burglaries in the central parishes. Following public assistance, a suspected prolific burglar was arrested on Wednesday afternoon in Pembroke and taken into custody awaiting a court appearance. The police also asked that residents continue to report any suspicious activity in their neighborhoods, especially unfamiliar individuals and vehicles entering or leaving the area. Police are aware of such persons attending homes after claiming to be Cablevision employees working in the vicinity. Residents are advised to verify the identities and intentions of any unsolicited individuals by contacting the relevant company or calling the police at 295-0011. With the rumor persisting that the OBA cabinet has approved just a handful of the Sage Commission's 20 major recommendations, VSB News' Charles Webb asked Premier Craig Kenanier today just what impact the SAGE report has had on the government's plans for the year ahead.
Certainly, Minister Richards has been moving forward with some departments that he believed are areas that we could be looking at outsourcing or mutualizing. Those discussions will be had ongoing. There are no decisions that have been made as to whether or not we're mutualizing a particular department or outsourcing it. No decisions like that have been made at all. What has to happen first is that we need to sit down with the stakeholders, which is government officials, which is the unions in the private sector, and talk about these areas that we believe are potentials. What we don't want is a situation that we have in Barbados, where 3,000 civil servants are laid off. That is not where we want to go. What are the options that lie in front of us? And some of those options are mutualization and outsourcing. The reality that we are living in is that we have a government that can't sustain itself. So our revenue is not great enough for our spend. And we cannot continue on in that vein. Every year, you know, with a deficit of $300+ million is not sustainable. And that's why we're looking at efficiencies and cutting back where we can, but at the same time maintaining jobs.
So isn't it fair to say then those who take over the outsourcing, the mutualization, wouldn't they have to find themselves in the position of laying off people?
Well, you know, when it comes to mutualization, really the stakeholders in that are those who may be within civil service. If they're going into an entity and, you know, you just name whatever the industry may be, they will then become the stakeholders of that industry, securing their jobs and securing their interests going forward. Certainly with outsourcing, there is some risk there, and that's why we need to talk about what is the options, the real options in front of us. I like the idea of mutualization if there's some other things that are involved, but certainly, for instance, the Tourism Authority. We ensured that when the Tourism Authority came in that we would absorb any jobs that might have thought to be lost into government. So we're going to be looking at all of these factors. I don't believe that we don't have options. We do have options, but the one option we don't want is to go the route of Barbados and laying off thousands of people. That's not the route we want to go. And I believe that there are answers out there that can resolve that.
Coincidentally, opposition Senate leader Diallo Rabane brought up the subject of the Sage Commission's impact on the budget when he spoke during the Senate debate on the budget yesterday.
The SAGE report came up with some laudable recommendations. Some good things were there, some things that people were like, you know. But, Madam President, one of the promises that was made by the Premier in December of that year is that we will have town hall meetings to educate Bermuda on the SAGE recommendations. Before we do anything, before we say anything, the premier went on television, went in the newspaper and all of that, and that's what he said. To date, we have not had not one town hall meeting, but we've come back with a budget that speaks to SAGE, that speaks to privatization, it speaks to mutualization, and the like. And we sit back and we wonder why the people were getting upset. They don't understand. Why they don't understand? Because we haven't told them. We haven't explained to them what exactly this stuff means, what exactly is the impact that's going to happen to them. And it isn't like they're saying, why you ain't done it? They're saying, you said you was going to do it. So please, please tell me. You know, sometimes if you explain something ahead of time and you do it correctly, it goes by a lot smoother. People can accept it, people can listen, and people can get an appreciation for what you're trying to do. I can say honestly, I'm exasperated. I just can't see why it happens week in, week out. I honestly can't. I had a long talk with an old UBP politician yesterday, and he said, you know, the one thing missing is there's no one in there that understands the people. Maybe that's the kick. But I just can't see why you want to continue to look and feel as if you're comfortable breaking your promises and not following through with your word. Why?
Still ahead is Che with the weather preview.
Thanks, Peter. Hey, let's take a look at the Doppler radar. Well, not much going on right now. A little moisture off in the distance, but with this great day, will it continue? Boy, I hope so. I'll have more coming up later.
The weather radar picture provided courtesy of the Ministry of Transport on VSB TV 11.
You can count on us.
Save half price on juicy, sweet cantaloupes, just $2.99 each. XL Fresh Country Style Pork Spirits, $2.49 per pound. Clean up with Bounty Paper Towel, $2.99 for one big roll. $1.89 for a 30-ounce bottle of ShopRite Regular Ultra Bleach. Save $2.10 on Tide 2X Original Scent Laundry Detergent, just $9.99 for a 50-ounce bottle. Visit our website at www.marketplace.pm for more super specials.
You can count on us.
Copyfax is Bermuda's authorized Samsung dealer. See a large range of Samsung color and black and white multifunctional machines, printers, scanners, faxes, and copiers, and all networkable. Copyfax has Samsung machines suitable for home, office, or any size business in an A4 format, taking up less room than other similar equipment. And replacement supplies are in stock for all of their Samsung products. Affordable shopping at Copyfax Limited, where service comes first.
Digicel Postpaid Refresh is here. Get any of the latest smartphones with no money down. Easy monthly payments start at only $10 per month. Choose from a wide range of devices. Pay absolutely nothing up front. And only $35 per month for a Samsung Galaxy S4 or $40 per month for a BlackBerry Q10. And then upgrade to a new smartphone whenever you like. Digicel Postpaid Refresh for all Digicel customers. Join Digicel today. Now you can bring your number with you. Visit DigicelBermuda.com for details. Be extraordinary. Digicel.
Buying a new bike? Go with the company that offers brand name quality and great after-sales service. Oleander Cycles. Whether you're a daily commuter looking for a reliable ride or business owner sourcing wheels for your delivery team, you'll find bikes to suit your needs at Oleander Cycles. Oleander carries quality bikes from respected manufacturers PGO and TGB, and a full line of accessories from helmets to top boxes and baby seats. Just as important as the bike is the service behind it. Oleander delivers with 7-day-a-week service in our 4 locations, same-day service with appointment, an extensive inventory of parts, and a 6-month warranty on new bikes. Visit our Hamilton or Paget showroom today. Best bike, best service, Oleander Cycle.
The $750,000 grant provided to the Corporation of St. George's is proving to be money well spent. Today, the mayor of the old town, Garth Rothwell, invited Home Affairs Minister, Senator Michael Fay, to view upgrades recently underway.
We've just been shown the work that's been put into the dock here at Penno's Wharf. Had a huge hole in it from Hurricane Fabian as long ago as that. That had a risk of basically falling into the sea if it wasn't repaired. So that's a tremendous thing to see. Tourists, when they come off in the summer in the ferries, will now see the immediate improvements, as will the locals. And indeed, we're going to be going down in a few moments down to the other wharf to have a look at, I believe, the new vehicles have been purchased to continue the work in the town for collection of refuse and the like. So it's very positive, and it's the instantaneous change that you can see with just that little bit of extra funding that's required to keep things in a better state.
These are mainly repairs to our docks, which if we hadn't carried them out, the concern was when another hurricane came through, we'd have an even bigger hole and even have to spend even more money. So that was one of the reasons for doing this. But as the minister's just said, it also means that when we have our tourists walking by here in another month or so, they don't see a dock that's about to fall into the sea. Down on Ordnance, we believe that the main concern there was the thrusters from the cruise ship have knocked a hole in it. And that's been the case for about 6 years. It's been like that at least. And again, if we have no cruise ships, so there's no longer that problem. But again, if we had a big hurricane come in, our real concern, that would be even worse than here. It would take out a good bit of the parking lot there on Ordnance Island, if it was bad enough and lasted long enough. You know, the longer they go on, the more damage they do. And going to our trash trucks, were 12, 13 years old, and you know how long a vehicle lasts in Bermuda, especially when you're using it every day and you're using it to go around and collect trash. And in St. George's, we have to have the small trash trucks because the bigger ones cannot get up the small streets.
Property, home, automobile, and motorcycle insurance being sold by at least one friendly society in Bermuda is not regulated by the Bermuda Monetary Authority. This from Craig Swan, managing director of the BMA, who says accordingly it does not have to comply with solvency or liquidity requirements that apply to domestic insurers under the Insurance Act of 1868. Mr. Swan adds that members or potential members of a friendly society which is offering insurance policies may not be aware that such entities are outside the scope of existing insurance legislation and regulation in Bermuda, and thus are not currently regulated for that purpose by the authority. The authority's view is that no financial services product should be sold without appropriate regulatory oversight. Now, here's the reinsurance business report, presented by Bermuda Re.
Bermuda Reinsurance News, brought to you by Bermuda Re. Calista Global is set to launch a cyber terrorism pricing product that will help the industry move away from an esoteric view of risk and towards an accurate and informed view of cyber exposure. This from Spencer Conway, CEO of Calista Global, who tells Bermuda Re that the goal of the company's new product, Cyber Price, is to deliver the industry standard in the pricing of cyber risk that will help global firms to accurately assess their cyber exposures while offering solutions to mitigate their risk. JLT Towers Re, which was formed following the JLT Re's acquisition of Towers Watson Re's global operations, has launched an expanded Bermuda platform as it looks to develop deeper ties with Bermuda carriers. Bradley Maltese, who will head up the company's Bermuda operations, describes Bermuda as a key marketplace and says that the merger will provide further impetus to JLT Towers Re's growth aspirations in a number of classes of business. Bermuda-based insurance has launched a new data breach product, Breach Assist, which will provide insureds with coverage for legal costs, forensic analysis, and customer interaction following a data breach. The product launch comes hot on the heels of well-publicized losses at the likes of Target and Sony. Breach Assist will sit alongside and complement Endurance's premier professional offering and is aimed at retail, healthcare, financial institutions, and professional service firms. Insurance investment manager Catco has launched Aquilo, a fund that will be the firm's first pursuing a traditional reinsurance investment strategy. The fund will offer investors exposure to global reinsurance risk, insurance-linked securities, and other financial instruments and will have short-term focus on returns. The fund will focus on the underserved small to medium-sized insurance market. Tokio Marine and Nikito Fire Insurance, the property and casualty subsidiary of Tokio Marine, has issued a $245 million Bermuda-based bond for Japanese earthquake risk. Kaizuna Re 2 is the second catastrophe bond transaction issued by Tokyo and follows the success of the company's 2011 bond, Kaizuna Re. That's Bermuda Reinsurance News, brought to you by Bermuda Re.
Now, here is a look at the daily markets, presented by Bias.
Global equity markets edged lower today as investors positioned for a speedier rise in U.S. interest rates than previously thought. But Wall Street traded higher on better-than-expected economic reports. North American indices gained as economic data overshadows rate rise concerns. The Dow Jones Industrial increased 0.67% to 16,331. Bank of NT Butterfield closed at $1.98, unchanged on the day, with 192,423 shares trading hands. Keytec Limited dropped 3.58% to $5.11, with 1,500 shares trading hands. 500 shares of BFNM were traded today. UK stocks retreated for a second day after Federal Reserve Chair Janet Yellen indicated that U.S. interest rates will rise 6 months after the central bank's monthly bond purchases come to an end next fall. Pacific Rim indices were down on the day after Federal Reserve Chair said the central bank stimulus program may end this fall. The Hang Seng Index dropped 1.79% to 21,182. Latin American indices were up on the day. Brazil's Bovespa rose 1.52% to 47,276 as state-run companies rallied on speculation a poll will show diminished support for the country's president. Treasury 10 to 30-year curve is the narrowest since 2010 after Federal Reserve indicated interest rates may rise faster than expected. The U.S. 10-year yield remained at 2.77%. The U.S. dollar strengthened versus the euro and the British pound after the Fed makers signaled that they will probably raise interest rates by the middle of next year. The Canadian dollar increased 0.01% versus the U.S. dollar to $1.12. And that was a look at the daily markets presented by Bias.
Save $1.50 on a family pack of Purdue fresh chicken thighs, $1.99 per pound. Juicy Bartlett Pears, just 89 cents each. Only $1.39 for a 1 pound box of Ronzoni Albo macaroni. Save 90 cents on ShopRite Pure Cane Sugar, $2.39 for a 4 pound bag. Save $1.34 on Nestle's Gold Cereal, $4.49 for a 460 gram box. All stores open Monday through Saturday until 10 p.m. and Sunday 9 to 7 p.m. for your shopping convenience.
For much more furniture, visit Bermuda's only Ashley Furniture Gallery. Big Saving Zone. You want the best? Forget the rest. For all your furniture needs, shop Big Saving Zone and support your local retailers. Have you ever ordered something online expecting it to be a certain price, but when it arrives, it ends up being a whole lot more? Beware of those unexpected hidden fees. That never happens at Big Saving Zone. Open Tuesday through Saturday, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Big Saving Zone, at the end of Stocks Road, St. David's.
With Cell One, you simply get more. More 4G speed and reliability across the island. More warranty coverage from the only carrier authorized to resell Apple iPhones in Bermuda. More first-class service with our 24/7 customer care, whether you're in-store, on the phone, or online. More services, mobile phones, long distance, and home internet, all with one company. Get more with One. Cell One.
After celebrating Happy Day in a number of ways today, Bermudians appeared to have been left with the question, why isn't every day a happy day? A point that could well be put to the United Nations and might also apply to Peace Day as well. To bring the day to a close, here is what the students at Dalton E. Tucker Primary School were inspired to create by their art teacher Robin Hooper, a good way to end the news segment.
It might the way.
Because I'm happy.
Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof.
Because I'm happy.
Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth.
Because I'm happy.
Clap along if you know what happiness is to you.
Because I'm happy.
Clap along if you feel like that's what you want to do. Here come bad news, talking this and that.
April is Environmental Awareness Month, and VSB is committed to bringing you important facts. 1450 AM Gold and Mix 106 FM will broadcast Did You Know vignettes and interviews with local experts and government officials during the month of April. VSB TV 11 will show documentary films such as climate change, pollution and overfishing of our oceans, clean air, sewage, vanishing of the bees, and other topics. April is Environmental Awareness Month. Stay tuned to VSB Radio and Television for details.
The largest soccer tournament on Bermuda's annual calendar takes place this weekend when 1,000 young players and 2,000 families and friends will flock to the National Stadium for the annual Kappa Classic put on by the alumni of the Kappa Alpha Psi fraternity. And as Chairman Zane Howe and Director Jamal Hart explain, this year's Soccer Fest from Friday night to Sunday afternoon will include some new features.
On behalf of the Brothers of Kappa Alpha Psi Bermuda Alumni Chapter, we would like to welcome you to participating in watching and joining us at the National Sports Complex for Kappa Classic 2014. This year we are happy to hold it entirely at the National Stadium Complex. It is going to be the annual competition, which will comprise of 74 teams this year. Boys' ages begin at under 8, division to under 14. The girls' ages will begin at under 10, and they will encompass under 12s and under 14s as well. The competition this year has a unique factor of being able to say for the first time that it is an international competition. It is being supported with the John Smith Soccer Academy from overseas, the USA. They come from the Massachusetts, New England area, and I'll let Brother Hart expound on that.
Yes, as Brother Zane just said, the John Smith Soccer Academy, JSSA, will be gracing our shores for the very first time. We are very excited about it. They have an under 12 and an under 14 team, and from what we understand, that their under 12 team did exceptionally well in the New England area this past season, finishing in the top three of their division. So it's an unknown factor for both the Bermudian teams and for the USA team, in that neither of them know what the other teams are capable of doing.
It begins Friday evening, March 21st at 6 p.m. are the first games. These are the preliminary rounds. It will proceed to the Saturday, all day Saturday, March 22nd. Games start at 8:30 in the morning and proceed on until 6 p.m. in the evening. Throughout the day, there will be all sorts of other announcements being made, and the finals will be on Sunday. The earlier round games begin at 9 a.m. and they proceed on to approximately 1 p.m. in the afternoon. The Classic continues to be the largest local soccer competition held on the island, and we're looking forward to being able to continue with that representation by putting on another Classic this year.
Choose to be healthy, Bermuda. Get out there and exercise with a sunscreen hat and shirt on every day. Eat healthy, don't smoke, and check your brown spots once a month to detect skin cancer early. anything growing darker, bigger, jagged borders needs to be checked. Wear your sunscreen, hat, and shirt every day. Be sun safe, Bermuda.
Well, today was the International Day of Happiness, and if today did not make you happy, I don't think you and I are going to be friends. I'm Che Barker, and this is your weather. Let's take a look at our weather shot for today. Today's weather shot taken by Seanette Sumner at 8:15 over Ely's Harbor. And as you can see here, it was well on its way to just being an absolute gorgeous day. Not really hot, but just blue skies. You can see the flat, calm waters here. Well on its way to being awesome. And let me tell you, I had a great time. I stopped by the beach. It was beautiful. Our highs and lows for today, well, it got all the way up to 71, but it's still a little bit of a chill in the air at 1 p.m., but our low temperature, 64 at 5:30 a.m. this morning. Currently, we're looking at 69 degrees. The humidity is 65%. Winds out of the south-southwest at 10 knots, and the barometric pressure is falling at 29.95 inches. For March, so far we've seen 2.58 inches worth of rain. Brings our total all the way up to 16.89 inches. It's eased off a little. We normally have seen 13.17 inches up to now. Take a look at our satellite map. Well, a weak high pressure is going to continue to move out tonight as that tail front, the cold end, approaches from the west. Now, winds will increase tonight with a few showers Friday morning through the afternoon as that front then passes on by. High pressure will then build in through this weekend, bringing fair weather, but a low approach is late on Sunday, bringing some unsettled conditions by the night. In the Gateway Cities, it'll be mostly sunny and 70 in Atlanta, 56 and partly cloudy in Boston, Charlotte mostly sunny and 70 degrees, 50 and partly cloudy in London, 82 and mostly sunny in Miami, New York mostly sunny and 49 degrees, Orlando partly cloudy and 83, Philadelphia mostly sunny and 54. Ha, good news, Toronto, my wife's going there tomorrow, partly cloudy and 39. Ha ha, Washington partly cloudy and 59 degrees. For tonight, we're looking at a low temperature of around 63 degrees, mostly cloudy, one or two showers late on at night, winds out of the south-southwest at 8 to 12 knots, and then they're moving out of the southwest at 10 to 15 knots. For tomorrow, high temperature around 68, sunny breaks, a few morning showers, showers in the morning and into the afternoon. High of winds out of the west at 12 to 18 knots, then they'll be in the northwest by midday, and out of the north-northwest at night. For mariners tonight, there is a small craft warning in effect. Seas inside the reef, 1 to 2 feet. Seas outside the reef, 5 to 9 feet. And sea temperature, 66 degrees. For mariners tomorrow, no warnings in effect. Seas inside the reef, 1 to 2 feet. Seas outside the reef, 4 to 7 feet. Low tide is at 6:27 a.m. and high tide, 12:11 p.m. Take a look at the 5-day forecast. Friday, sunny breaks, a few showers in the morning and afternoon, high of 68. Saturday, partly cloudy, high of around 66. Sunday, mixes sun and clouds, a few overnight showers, high of 68. Monday, mostly cloudy, occasional showers, chance of thunder, high of 68. And on Tuesday, mostly cloudy, overnight periods of rain and cooling off all the way down to 64. I'd like to thank the Bermuda Weather Service for all their help, and a special shout-out, as always, to my friends down at English Sports Shop, Alexander's London, helping me look good. Thanks a lot. Everyone else, I'll see you again tomorrow.
Thanks for watching the TV 11 News. Good night.
Peter Cattell's attire, courtesy of A.S. Cooper & Sons Limited.
VSB, TV 11, Bermuda.